Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to do a nipple conversion for the Epson ET-8550. Basically, we take a printhead of ET-8550, we change the ink intake from a mesh input to a nipple input on the right. Now we need to take this cover off. See, this cover has two tabs, one on each side, and then there are two screw holes in the front. So we just unscrew the two screws in the front and lift up the tabs and remove the cover. Now you remove the two screws from transportation lock assembly. I already converted this printer into drag chain and replaced the tubes to clear tubes. So this video I'm going to cover both the OEM tubes and the clear tube. If you have a drag chain, you absolutely do not need this transportation lock assembly at all. So just pretend we have OEM tubes and now we disconnect all the tubes. Now we can detach assembly from the dampers. We try to suck ink out of each damper. Whenever I mention product, I am going to put a SKU on the bchtechnologies.com, and also I'm going to put a direct link on the top right corner. There will still be a whole bunch of ink left in the damper. And now I'm going to remove it by park the printhead carriage on the capping station. By park, I mean you turn the printer on and wait until it rests on the capping station naturally. The outlet of the waste tube should be right here. However, I modified this printer. I took the waste tube out. Here is the outlet. So now I attach to the waste tube. I'm going to draw slowly. This is speed up. I don't draw this fast. You're going to draw slowly until the ink is empty. Now we're ready to take dampers out. We flip the metal tab towards you. We can lift up the damper vertically. You're going to do the middle one first. Use the syringe to clean it up. Use a paper towel to dab everything dry before unscrew the printhead. There are four screws to remove and the printhead can be lifted straight up. You can see, although we're being really careful, we still have a fair amount of ink coming down on the bottom. Look at the ink here. Oh, by the way, if this is too much for you, we also offer conversion installation service. Look how much ink it has. Since we're already here, not only we're going to convert, and also we're going to show you how to seal the printhead. On the BCH website, we have a small silicone seal for those. However, this video is sponsored by the DTF Pro. So we can go to dtfpro.com and search for the word silicon. And it is this waterproof bundle, which has a silicon seal and also the pad for cleanup. It comes in as a pretty large tube, which is more than what I expected. And these pads are for cleanup, so you wipe off if you get too much stuff on it. And also come with a really detailed instruction. That's a whole lot of silicone for your money. And just show you for the BCH, you have a precision tip, but it's much smaller than the DTF Pro. So if you seal lots of printhead, definitely DTF Pro is better value. For all the silicone seals, the first thing we want to do is test the conductivity. We got some BCH seal on the bottom, and on the top, the white one is the DTF Pro. And they both doesn't conduct any electricity. That means you can apply them and install them without waiting them to set. You can install them wet. Now we remove the four screws. And we're ready to take off the printhead from its base. You want to keep that black rubber seal there. Don't touch it. Oh, this tip going to save your life. See the base and this tab? Where on the other side have a serial number. That goes the side with two holes on the top. So you don't want to install this upside down. Now it's new over new base. We put the side of a serial tab on the top. We put the side of a two holes on the top and put it in. And now we put the four screws in. You want to tighten the two diagonal screws first. Then you go around, tighten each one. And now we're ready to waterproof it. There are other things you can do. For example, you can put a printed cover. And we also have a printed sleeves. But for this video, we simply applied a silicon seal. This edge is most likely the ink going to get in. Here's where the cleanup pad is used for. If you ever got a tile or seal your toilet before, and you got idea. The last thing you want to seal is the FFC cable, but you have to install the cable first, then seal it. Oh, don't do this. I'm just showing you, you have a nipple now, so you can do this, those stuff. Okay, put it back to the printer. We still use the V2 damper, and we're trying to redesign a V3 damper, and it didn't work. So we go back to V2 damper. The problem with this damper is a little bit taller than we want, and the ink come in from the top. If you have a drag chain installed, you do not need this printhead lock assembly. But if you do not have a drag chain installed, you need this assembly to hold this clear tube guard. I'll show you how to work with both. With OEM tube, this assembly is too long, so for the dampers that go to the middle, it cannot be set securely, and so you have to sand down or cut off at the top piece of the assembly. Get a Dremel tool, it takes like 5 minutes, or you can just get the sandpaper, sand it down. But the good thing is the OEM tube fits in the white damper perfectly. And if you need a longer tube, you can take this top off of the lock. It's all tapped, so just remove the tabs and this thing gonna come off. So you can only install the bottom of the assembly, then attach the tubes, put the clear plastic tube guard back into the bottom of the assembly. Okay, for the clear tubes, the damper is connection size number 3. My tube is number 2. So I got a regular elbow. Those elbows, one side is a size 2, another side is a size 3. So I got a piece of C3 size tubes. That tube is going to attach the elbow and then attach to the damper. Another thing is I can cut the elbows a little bit shorter on the C3 side. That will save more space on the top. Now I need to fill all the dampers with ink. So I just get a regular syringe and just draw it. The ink is going to come flow into the dampers. And notice I don't have the cartridge lock assembly installed, so prevent the tubes to hit the printer. See, the tubes usually wrap and hit this part of the printer. So I install this simple tube holder. It has two screws that goes right in the two holes left by the bottom of the lock assembly. I push the tube down. So see, if the tube goes to this side, I will not hit the printer. Then I park the printhead on the capping station and slowly draw a little bit of ink, and you should feel slight resistance, and that will prime the new printer now, or you can just go back and enjoy. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.